No war with Iran!
No war with Iran! No war with Iran!
No war with Iran!
Iran!
No war with Iran!
No war with Iran!
No war with Iran!
No war with Iran!
If you are not outraged, you are not paying attention.
I'm concerned about a war with Iran.
There is a sense of deja vu with what is happening with Iran.
I'm here in order to stop the nuclear war and asking to Barack Obama to say no, not this time.
But I am here because the next war that the Americans start is going to be a nuclear war, because that's the only way they can defeat a country these days.
You have heard the announcements that war on Iran is coming, and you have had deja vu because you have seen the whole charade before and its ultimate goal. You have seen it with Iraq, and you have seen it with Afghanistan, and you have seen what it accomplished, and you have seen what it did not accomplish, and you are seeing it now with Iran. You have heard lots about war on Iran in the near future. Is crazy for peace for or against Iran? Neither. We're against war anywhere for whatever reason.
The initiative taken by Crazy for Peace is important because of the need to make people aware that the danger of war against Iran is real and that we must do everything possible to prevent it from occurring. If we are to learn anything from the disasters of Afghanistan and Iraq, it is that we are not isolated from these events. Canada played a major combat role in the 1991 invasion of Iraq, a support role in the 2003 war in Iraq, and became directly involved in the occupation of Afghanistan through its current combat role. Given this history, one would expect that Canada would be a participant or certainly support any action taken against Iran.
I think Einstein was the one who said that World War III would be fought with nuclear weapons. The next World War will be fought with sticks and stones.
Step one, alarm the public. Begin with media reports of human rights abuses, media reports of terrorism, media reports of suspected nuclear weapons, media reports of suspected weapons of mass destruction being stockpiled. Step two, follow up with economic sanctions. Step three, encourage an internal military coup against the elected government. Step four, wage military war as a last resort. Starting to sound familiar? Iraq, Afghanistan, North Korea, Cuba, Venezuela, 1970s Chile, Nicaragua, Palestine. Recognize the signs.